Not so long ago, Pepechenequia Mole lived on the banks of the Mississinewa near Peru, Indiana. He spent his days on the edge of a prairie, tunneling beneath the tall grass. After a long day, as night began to fall, Pepechenequia was digging a new tunnel when he came across a Sena rock. A Sena wasn't very special looking, just an ordinary white Sena buried in the earth. A Sena was very large. Pepechenequia didn't feel like digging around such a very large rock. He asked a Sena, "How did you get here, so deep in the ground?" A Sena, who hadn't spoken to anyone in a very long time, said, "My story starts long ago. I used to live beneath the water of an ocean, side by side with the shells and the fish. One day I saw an otter dive down near me and pick up a rock. Soon, all of the water drained away, and I found myself part of the land. I liked living above the water. Each day, the sun would warm me, and every night, the moon and stars would shine brightly. Soon, grass and trees began to grow upon me. I could hear birds sing, thunder came each spring, and the snow fell each winter. As each prairie and forest grew and then died, they formed a thick layer of earth over the top of me. It was dark beneath the soil, but it covered me like a warm blanket. I thought I might never see the sun again. One day, rain began to fall. It started as a trickle, and that trickle carried away some of the soil covering me. Each spring, when the thunder came and brought the rain, a little more earth would be carried away. It took many, many moons, but eventually a river formed. As the river grew year after year, it eventually carried away the rocks above me, below me, and all around me. I was part of a cliff and at the top of a cave. I still couldn't see the sun, but I saw a new kind of light. A few times a year, a group of elder men, they called themselves Miamia, would gather in the cave. They called the place Ashipequa Wawaleche, Seven Pillars. The fires they lit warmed me, and I liked the sweet smell of the smoke. As the winters passed, the river changed. Settlers from the east came and cut down the forests to build towns on the banks of the river. Eventually, no more canoes came down the river, and soon boats making loud noises started coming up and down the river. Sometimes families would picnic beneath me. Then the people stopped the water like beavers, with a large dam. Once a flood came, and I was washed away from the roof of the cave, carried down the stream, and buried beneath the soil. Again a prairie grew, and it was beneath the prairie that Asena and Pepechenequia first met. One day, a group came to the edge of the prairie. They called themselves Miami. They spent the day picking milkweed and mulberries. Pepechenequia heard the footsteps echoing in his tunnel. As dusk came, Pepechenequia came out to see Asena. About that time, a young Miami girl came over. Pepechenequia ducked back in his tunnel, but he could see the box that the girl was carrying. It said, "Asena Miamiongonje." Pepechenequia didn't know what that meant, but the girl got very excited when she saw Asena. She picked up a small piece that had fallen from Asena, running off yelling, "Inga! Mom! Look what I found!"